Well, maybe God did. Because one of the old metaphysical problems is, why would God allow evil into the world? You think, well, maybe God didn't allow evil into the world. Maybe God allowed the possibility of evil into the world. That's different. And maybe the world with the possibility of evil is actually a better world than the world without the possibility of evil. It's something like that. You know, in that maybe a man is better when he's a dangerous man who's being good than he would be if he was just a good man who wasn't capable of being dangerous. And I believe that, because the best men that I've ever met are very dangerous men. You don't mess with them. So, and you know that as soon as you meet them.
Do you think weak men can be virtuous?
No.
Because I think that when you're weak, let's say that signals that you don't have the options to sin.
Right.
Which is something that creates resentment. And resentment creates corruption.
Mm-hmm.
So in this sequence, do you think that someone without teeth or without the options to sin can be
good? See, that's a real theological question, right? Because the question you're asking is, this is tied up with the idea of free will and evil. Can a person who doesn't have the option to be evil be good? And I would say no. So maybe that's the reason that, metaphysically speaking, you know, I don't know where you are when you're speaking metaphysically exactly, but the question of why is there evil in the world is a constant question. It's like, it's possible that without the possibility of evil, there cannot be good. Good requires the possibility of evil. And maybe good is so good that the fact that it requires the possibility of evil is acceptable. Maybe it's even desirable. You know, you kind of end up on the edge of your knowledge when talking about such things, but it seems to me to be right.
Yeah.
And it seems to be right in a lived sense, you know, like, I met Jocko Willink, he's a good example. I mean, Willink was the commander in Ramada, I think, and, you know, you can say what you want about American military involvement, it has nothing to do with that, really, not at this level of analysis. He's a tough guy.
I follow him on Twitter.
Yeah, so you know.
He gets up every morning at 5:30, 4:30.
He's a tough guy. He told me, quite straightforward, that he was one of those kids that as an adolescent could have gone either way. Right?
Yeah.
He could have been highly successful street criminal.
Yeah, probably.
Right? But probably. Well, you can see it. But he decided not to do that. You know, he's very, I would say he's...
He was a SEAL, right?
Mm, that's right. He's psychophysiologically intimidating. He's a big guy. You can tell he knows how to use it. And you can tell he used it.
Yeah.
But as far as I can tell, he's a good person. And that's all of that capacity for mayhem is part of what makes him a good person. And people know that. That's why they're listening to him. And then, like I said, the other people I've met who are good men, they're all like that. They're all dangerous. They're all dangerous.
Yeah. Have they all been not good men before? Or is that not part of becoming a good man?
I would say they've certainly all done things that they...
One's at the train. Got the train in the armrest.